How you doing? Good to see you. I'm back. I'm gonna do a video today about conditioning. This is like some of my favorite conditioning exercises for wrestlers. We wanna build strength, we wanna build stamina, we wanna build athleticism. So these are like my 7 favorite exercises to do for high school level wrestlers and above. Work on it, here we go. So one of my favorite exercises is a power clean, right? This is, this combines a deadlift, right? A high pull, and then a catch as we pop with our hips and catch, and then we can put a front squat into it, we can put a push press. Super athletic, this is super technical. Probably my favorite lift because it forces them to be technical with their lift, okay? A good goal is for you to be able to clean your body weight, right? If we can get to the end of the workout, maybe 10 sets at your body weight, 10 sets of 2, 10 sets of 1, and as you get stronger, obviously you're gonna go up in weight. So hit a couple, you're just gonna do sets of 2 right now. Really focus on that technique. Jet's got really good technique. He does a little thing where he kind of bumps the bar with his thighs. I don't do that, but his works really well. His technique's probably better than mine. Do it again. High pull. Keep going. Power clean, probably my number one exercise for wrestlers. I'll tell you. Okay, so this is our harness stuff. Come back, show them the harness. There's no bungee on this. This is just a, you know, a strap with the harness on your shoulders. I like it on the shoulders, almost like like he's a horsey. I got a little horsey here, and I'm gonna make him go. Okay, so I'm gonna start walk all the way out. Start with a bear crawl. So I'm gonna hold him back, and he's gonna drag me with a bear crawl. Follow it, clean up. Giving him quite a bit of resistance, okay? And he's learning to drive through the position. You know, very functional for wrestling. He's gonna keep his hips low and drive. Here we go, do it again. I can make it as hard as I want, okay? I'm really making pull me. I'm actually getting a workout here too. Go, 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 stay wide with your feet, wide with your feet. Go, 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 faster. Good, good, good. Harder than it looks. Okay, we can go shots down the mat. So right now, we'll just go drop shot, continuous, and I want him to keep pulling me. So I don't want him to shoot and then take the pressure off. I want him to shoot and keep driving down the mat. Shot, boom, and then shuffle, drive. Shot, shuffle a little bit, okay? So you don't have to be shot, 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 and shot. Shuffle, pull, shot, shuffle, pull. Here we go. Here we go, horsey. Come on, horsey. Ready? Go. More explosive. Shot. Shot. Your head up. Shot. Good. Move your arms. Move your arms. Good. Okay, last two here. Just gonna have them sprint. Lean forward, sprint, hands on your knees. Catch your breath. Just gonna lean forward just like a sprint. Okay, you can go like a high knees action. And go out there until it starts to, you feel the resistance. And here we go, go. Awesome, one more. Great for your athleticism. Right, we gotta make them better athletes. Here we go. The more you feel the resistance, the more you snap. Here we go. Awesome. Speed harness, another one of my favorites. Good, go. Okay, bands. Okay, I really got on these from my good friend Ivan Dolchev. Dolchev said, hey, if you're not doing the bands, you're not doing nothing, okay? And that stuck with me. This is great resistance training. It's functional. I'm getting resistance both ways. I'm driving with my hips and my arms. This is great for after practice. You can put a whole match in, 7 minutes. Spent some time at the Olympic Training Center And I saw the Greco guys working on this every day after practice. They're putting 20 minutes on this a day. You wonder why those guys are so ripped. Really working that slow twitch muscle fiber in your upper body and your hips. Super functional. I love this one where you go over the elbows. Bang. You can work our shoulders. Our snap downs. High pulls. Biceps. Tell you what, you do this for 7 minutes, you'll feel it. Working your core, use your whole body. Okay? If you're not doing the bends, you're not doing bends. So good, okay? It's all about driving with your legs and pulling with your arms. This young man right here, you see these arms, he needs some weighted pull-ups in his life. So this is gonna really increase your grip strength, okay? And your overall power of your back, pulling in those single legs. Okay, we like to do sets of five so we make them perfect. We don't want sloppy ones, so knock out five. So a typical day, we might say, hey, 50 weighted pull-ups, sets of five. Okay, and we're looking for you to go perfect. Full extension, great job. If you notice how he's gonna wrap his thumbs every time, we don't do any of this hook stuff. It's all about your grip strength. So when you wrap your thumb around that bar, that really makes a difference on your grip strength. You can go chin ups now. Okay, pulling, full extension. Okay, over time, these will make a huge difference. Okay, weighted pull ups.
Get down.
Med ball. This is actually one of those smash balls, slam balls, they're made to slam. And we stole this one from Kyle Dake. Love all that functional pattern stuff. So much creativity with that. Who knows if it's really working, but we might as well throw it in because it's going to make us better. So we call these Kyle Dakes. He's going to grab the ball. He's going to pick it up. He's going to drop to his butt. Okay. Roll back. Kick his feet over his head. Kick the mat. Come back up, plant his feet, and you're gonna jump spike. Okay, do it again. Two sets of five or seven of these. These are great at the beginning of the practice, at the end of practice, working on coordination. It's a lot of core and a lot of athleticism to have to get up with that ball. Ideally, we want to jump spike. He's gonna jump and spike it. Okay, again. Obviously, add resistance by adding a heavier ball. You can do 15 or 20. I think 10 is about right for most kids. Two more. And jump spike. Good stuff. Let's call those Kyle Dakes. Get-ups. You've probably seen these before. I think these are pretty popular with CrossFitters. This is a 25-pound kettlebell. He's gonna lay flat on his back. He puts it up. You gotta keep the arm extended. He's gonna push off one arm to the side, get up, and he's gonna build, stack his body, stand all the way up. Okay, that's one. They're harder than they look, okay, because you need to coordinate and keep that arm locked out and stack your body, which is all just an idea to add more athleticism to our athletes. Make sure you go both sides, you can post that arm up. Notice how he rolls to one side, stacks his knee, and stand up. This is a 25-pound bell, so this is not easy. Do a couple more. You know, I love to throw this stuff in when kids are getting water. Hey, give me six Turkish get-ups on each side as soon as you get back on the mat. Hey, before practice starts, give me six Turkish get-ups on each side. Just a great way to cross-train. Way to go, okay? Turkish get-ups, do them. Here, so we over here. Alex, come over here. Okay, another one of my favorites. This is really eccentric loading. As we land and all the braking, it's breaking off those actin and myosin heads in your muscles. It's gonna make you really sore, but it's gonna build your legs back really strong. This is really a great way to do tendon training, right? So anytime we're doing jumping, we're really working on our tendon strength as well as our muscular strength. Alex has got a 17-pound bag on. He's gonna hold it tight to his body. When he jumps, he's gonna land like a spring, flat feet, and he's gonna put one jump into the next jump, all the way down. Go. Great job. Stretching at the bottom. Up with him. Land like a calf. Notice the full extension he's getting with each jump. Great job. A little rest at the bottom. Up. Turn around, do it again. All the way to the mat. You know, for this one, you know, Dolchev says, I got to make him hate the bag and make him hate. He's going to hate the bag after this one. Okay, do it again. Do it again. Make him hate the bag. This one will make you sore. It makes you so tired. Keep going. Keep going. Come on, land like a cat. Put some power and some endurance into that lower body. This will do it. Come on, let's go. Two more. Hey, now we're having fun, okay? My favorite 7 exercises for wrestlers, do them. It'll make you better.